can certainly do washes with a paintbrush, but with an airbrush, it's just so easy that I'd rather just knock it out. For this, I've got this scrap piece of, it originally was like a gas lens gate or something. The first thing you want to do is just have your paint crazy, crazy thin. So right now, it's the consistency of water, and that's what I want it to be. The reason airbrushes are so awesome at doing this is because they have the ability to really get in the cracks of your project. I'm going to do one half of this with black, and then I'm going to do the other half with more of a rust color. But as you see how it gets down in the crevices? And you don't miss any crevices with an airbrush. It's so much easier. Also, let me show you this too. See how wet it is? Of course it's wet because I've got it thinned out so much. Well, all I have to do is dry it out a little bit. So all I did was spray it really quick with super, super thin, like gunmetal gray and black mixed together. And I mean, look at that. In a pinch, it's almost good right there. And it's really cool because the wash gets down in the crevices and it looks really, really good. I'm gonna go over it one more time and show you one more cool thing. I did one more layer of dark, basically black, and I use a hairdryer to dry it off real quick. Now what I've done is you can either take a little bit of your reducer or you can take, you know, straight water. I always have both sitting around my projects. And use a scratchy pad. Scratchy pads are great, especially if you're doing like an industrial look, because they literally scratch the surface and they don't just wipe the surface. So they give you this kind of worn, scratchy look. And remember, illusion of detail, right? So I'm scratching in the direction that this object would normally be all scraped up and messed up. And you see what it's doing? It's pulling the color off the top and in the middle, but it's leaving those crevices. And this is so easy with water-based paints, because you can do this with water, you can do this with a little bit of your airbrush thinner, you know, really whatever you need, and it gives you a really, really good effect. So that really is the basics of a wash. Now, I used, you know, really dark gray, basically black, for this kind of industrial look. But if you want more of an old look, let's do rust. A lighter color, it takes a lot more, because remember, this is a wash. You are using super, super thinned out paint, and to get it to dry and also not take forever, I'm using a hairdryer in between coats. So over here with the black, or the, you know, really, really dark gray, it only took like one or two coats to kind of get the effect. For this side, it took three or four. So take my reducer, spray the corner of my scratchy. And then remember, we're just gonna take off the top. But don't just take off the top of the top pieces. Try to get them basically inside those lower crevices too. You can use, you know, the blotch it on there a little bit. So just take a little bit of your color and use a piece of newspaper or regular paper. Don't use paper towels, because paper towels soak up the paint so much that it just turns into a sponge, and you don't get that rough effect that you would from a piece of newspaper or a piece of, you know, heavyweight paper. But a lot of people are like, hey, I need it on there, or I want it a little bit thicker than just in the corners or just a wash. And of course, you can do that blotch method and really get a good effect as well. If you want to do the combo of the two, I think it looks fantastic. So the wash gets down in the crevices, and then the blotches stay kind of on top, but they're definitely more thick. And the contrast between them two really gives you a great illusion of detail. And remember what I said, illusion of detail is the trick here. I love painting, but I also love modeling and doing other stuff, and I don't want to spend all my time painting. So that's why I love tricks like this that can get me through and get me an effect really, really fast. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. If you've got any questions, you know where to check us out. CommanderDesigns.com. I'm Tony D.